No way out? The only and the perfect way out is the transformation of degenerated agricultural lands into carbon agroforests that produce and serve all that humans need, and does this in a sustainable manner and simultaneously solves all challenges. The total amount of agricultural land is 13 billion hectares worldwide. We totally depend on them for our food production, and roughly that is all these lands do for us all 8 billion humans. Actually, 30 to 40% of these for our survival essential agricultural lands already are degenerated, or already became unproductive. With the actual rate of degeneration, this already high percentage will have become a staggering 90% by the year 2050. No rocket science is needed to understand that when 90% of what we 8 billion humans totally depend on to stay alive will have become degenerated or unproductive, this will become a cause of at least one challenge. Most probably, this will become a wide variety of extreme challenges, including at least one direct challenge to our existence. It does not end here, because degenerated and unproductive lands are prone to become a cause of other challenges, like, amongst many other challenges, also dust storms. This is in fact so for the whole region, as well as for neighboring regions, that amongst others all can become prone to desertification, which can quickly become irreversible. There are historical and almost continental scale cases of all of these kinds and degrees of degeneration as well as challenges. This channel presents videos about some of these historical cases describing and explaining the challenges, and how they could have been prevented or remediated, and in fact how some of them in fact were successfully remediated with trees and forests. Back to the quickly degenerating agricultural soils. This evident and rapid degeneration, and increasing unproductivity, of agricultural soils from 30 or 40% to a whopping 90%, seems to be a very or rather recent and fast increasing phenomenon. It is clear that this phenomenon should get a lot of attention, something which at best is not the case. We should wonder why this phenomenon does not get a lot of attention, not even from activists. There are not many answers, apart from that we collectively do not care sufficiently or prefer to stay blind to what is really going on. This phenomenon also should have gotten a lot of additional attention, simply because soil degeneration is known to be a major cause of carbon dioxide emissions, and carbon dioxide emissions are known to get a lot of attention. So why does this quickly growing cause of carbon dioxide emissions does not seem to get any attention? Again, there are not many answers. Apart from that we do not care sufficiently or prefer to stay blind to what is really going on. Substantial loss of for existence essential climate regulation, locally and globally. Once more, it does not end here. While forests and especially carbon agroforests are the extreme active factor in climate regulation, agriculture, while its effect is fractional in comparison to carbon agroforest also is, and this matters, seeing their sheer size of 13 billion hectares, and even more so seeing their proximity to our cities and urban centers. Consequently, 90% of all our agricultural land becoming unproductive will become an additional, substantial, continuous source of emissions, as well as a global loss of the for existence essential climate regulation. Obviously, this climate regulation includes cooling of cities, especially so in certain cases of weather extremes. Repeating, when extensive areas of agricultural land become unproductive or less productive, these form a major problem for climate regulation, as well as for the also increasing and in fact new arising phenomenon of global jet stream instability. Jet stream stability is essential to prevent a wide range of to jet stream instability associated, and consequently also increasing calamities. Only one crossing event across the equator of a northern hemisphere jet stream in 2024 was sufficient to cause a series of strongly associated calamities, together forming an unprecedented global series of calamities, primarily and mostly in the northern hemisphere, but secondarily also in the seemingly much less affected southern hemisphere. As you can see, not only are we 8 billion humans quite unaware of the importance of agricultural lands and forests, also their effects are quite complex. Action and activists. In case those interested, and especially activists, really want to take care of one or more forests, rural areas, biodiversity, the planet, and our existence in general, what they can do is limited, but also could be very simple but solves all we 8 billion humans need, this even for all humans to thrive, this so at least with the right action plan in hand or developed. They let one, more or all important CEOs know they have a business plan for them, that is based on an action plan based on carbon agroforest, that they know that they themselves as well as a critical mass and more than sufficient of the essential partners. Like landowners as well as native people, will support. In the to the CEOs presented business plan, the activists of initiative takers need to and can provide evidence of the above. The activists of initiative takers themselves already have rather clear evidence that in this case the CEOs will support them, this simply so since several CEOs showed interest in the past, and even offered substantial money prizes to methods that remove substantial carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and carbon dioxide removal is a direct consequence, not the main aim at all, of the action plan based on carbon agroforest. In this proposal, carbon dioxide removal is a direct consequence, and not the main aim, of the action plan that is based on carbon agroforests. So if activists and initiative takers really look for a solution, preferring a solution over practicing politics, which are both provingly ineffective in this particular case, they should direct their efforts to incentivize others to take action, that they cannot execute themselves, rather to CEOs, which if convinced indeed can take action, and not in the first place to politicians, who even if convinced will not be the ones to take action and or make the difference. 1. More or all important CEOs can and will check such an action plan as well as the evidence, and eventual guarantees for success, and estimate and or calculate how much the action plan will cost them and what it will offer them, as they will see any such action plan, also or in the first place as their business plan. What such an action plan, or for the CEO such a business plan, can offer is beyond doubt historically unedited and surpasses by far all former business plans ever in their reach. An example of the scale of the action plan and business plan. The EV market is for CEOs a looked-for market, and an eventual important part of their business plan. Also, and at least partially for this reason, it is a competitive market, and seen some seemingly ongoing global economic downturn, also a difficult market. Still at best all is only regarding a share of only a still modest part of the automotive market, and the same industry as well as or more the automotive industry receives or batters an unedited competition from kind of its own product, that is Uber-like services and especially autonomous passenger and goods driving or transporting taxi-like vehicles, which independently and from the standpoint of sustainability etc. are of enormous potential. Since carbon agroforests ideally produce all what humans need, and this in a sustainable and in fact for free way or manner, with no cost at all for the basic materials, it or they or the to them related industry can transform and dominate in only a matter of a few years all markets and all industries. Obviously that is something totally unedited and surpasses many times all earlier industrial revolutions, since these never also fully incorporated and or took over, or replaced all other important economic activities, including agriculture, but also petrochemicals, forestry as well as mining. That includes and or affects agricultural machines. Inclusive, carbon agroforests can and should produce both 100% renewable and carbon dioxide removing electricity for electric vehicles, as well as 100% renewable and carbon dioxide removing gasoline plus, as well as all synthetic fuels and drop-in fuels for all kinds of cars and all kinds of vehicles including for agricultural machines. Or rather the for sustainability desirable expected agricultural robots and drones, that will replace expensive heavy and gas guzzling, as well as soil compacting and degenerating agricultural and forestry machines. For CEOs this makes for clear possibilities for unedited business plans, with all elements and markets that possibly could be of their interest, that they cannot afford to miss out on. Please be aware that there will be no soil tilling in the 100 times more productive carbon agroforests, simply because it is not needed, and in fact near destructive for carbon agroforests. These aspects are the subject of several other of our videos, which provide several unique information around sustainability, thriving and solving of challenges, as well as other subjects. Something similar is going on for the ever bigger agricultural machines market. This agricultural machines market, and indirectly all markets will be negatively affected by the fast and global degeneration of agricultural lands. At the same time you can easily see which markets, if not all markets, and in fact all politicians, including all media, could have a very short-term interest that the general public remains unaware for the here presented potentially dire evolution. In case those interested and especially activists really want to take care of one or more forests, rural areas, biodiversity, the planet, and our existence in general, what they can and should do is informed in this channel. What this channel does, amongst many other things, is provide for free and this in several languages, such an action plan, as well as such business plan, which obviously can be adapted and or improved or completed by all involved parties, if this would prove necessary or useful. What this channel also does, is providing the needed information, evidence, or even clear proof for all its claims. The main author of this video was a research leader and international consultant related to management of tropical forest in order to prevent degeneration and clear cutting of forests, especially tropical forests like also the Amazon forest, as well as the development and optimization of carbon agroforests, this to guarantee their preservation, as well as the effective indirect preservation of all preserved natural forests, again including the Amazon forest, and this in close cooperation with native peoples. To complete this video, we present the enormous and not known and not recognized potential of tropical forest and even tropical agriculture to produce all materials, goods, and services that we 8 billion humans need, as well as will make them thrive as never before, but also their unedited potential to remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere in quantities that surpass that what activists and CEOs dare to dream of, but are unaware of. It is not about a new 1 billion hectares of production lands. Instead, it is about transforming 1/13 of existing agricultural land, and in fact only a part of the 30-40% of agricultural land that is already degenerated and possibly already unproductive. The 1 billion hectares of transformed production land is still less than 1/3 of the already degenerated and possibly already unproductive land. Just to make sure, the degenerated and unproductive agricultural we are talking about are not deserts, etc., but once normally productive agricultural land that degenerated and unproductive because of agricultural activity and obvious practices. So this 1 billion hectares of the intercarbon agroforest transformed land produces 4 times all the food of the world, when using only 10% of its production capacity, to produce exclusively food, and in fact 4 times the amount of food that is actually and globally produced. Another 10% of the same transformed land is needed to produce all natural gas-like fuels that the whole world actually consumes. Another 60% of the 1 billion hectares of carbon agroforest needs to be dedicated to the production of gasoline and gasoline-like fuels that includes diesel, at least when this is in order to offset all fossil gasoline-like fuels. When these are offset, obviously their evident emissions also are. Finally, the not main objective of removing all post-industrial carbon dioxide out of the Earth's atmosphere. Last but not least, but still clearly last, so there is no mistake of it being a primary aim or some main objective. Amongst other, to remove all post-industrial carbon dioxide from the atmosphere in much less than 20 years, at no additional effort or cost. This apart from the simultaneous and possibly even more important climate and calamity regulating effects. Hopefully this makes it clear that we humans are blind or blinded for or to our potential, more specifically for the potential of carbon agroforests, most specifically for our existence. Hopefully this makes it clear this partial use of already degenerated or already unproductive agricultural lands kind of terraforms the Earth to a planet where 8 billion humans, and in fact much more, can thrive or rather effectively will thrive. This while regulating and even controlling the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere. How can so many people be blind or blinded for this and for so long? We claim that people stay unaware of the clear fact that agriculture at least once a year destroys all existing vegetation, all of the existing soil structure and significant part of its production capacity, this before replacing, and with great cost, with a soil structure and artificial fertility that will not last nearly a year. Also importantly, the planted crops have to start out from scratch, while the land largely remains uncovered and unproductive, this at least each year again. All the subjects of this video are extensively analyzed and explained in a number of other videos of our channel.